boasts some of the most breathtaking scenery in the province. Ship Cove, Kirby's Cove, Collins Cove, Burin North, and Burin Bay, just some of the fishing communities that make up the town of Burin. A blend of rugged hills and quiet inlets that have sheltered their inhabitants since the early 1700s. And like most Newfoundland outports, today they're a blend of the old and the new. Bungalows and salt box houses, wood piles and video stores, the very young against a backdrop of the very old. And Burin views its heritage with something akin to reverence. 72-year-old Tom Antle is a big hit at the Burin Peninsula Folk Festival, held every summer at Burin's Jameson Academy. Been singing since he was a boy and now has nearly 200 old songs in his repertoire.
Well, I don't think they'll ever be forgotten. I don't think they'll ever die out, you know.
And they won't die out if the people of Burin have their way. The folk festival is a big event in this area. 3 days of traditional step dancing, singing, and playing in their own unique styles. There's something for everyone, even the occasional non-traditional song in the children's tent.
Actually, the weather's been pretty warm and sunny this year, but when it comes to their festival, the good folks of Burin take no chances. The activities are always held indoors. Organizers refuse to let bad weather force them into last-minute changes. And they're just as determined to resist long-term change. When it comes to folk tradition and festivals, they call themselves purists.
We try to be. It's a struggle. I'm afraid perhaps that in some quarters the festival is looked on as a talent show, you know, and you don't like to see people taking the latest song off the radio and coming and performing it. But we're very lucky here that we have a lot of people who've kept their culture, and people who resettled from the islands of Placentia Bay and brought their songs and music with them.
Matthews is the driving force behind the folk festival and the founder of Burin's Penny Folk Dancers, a group of young people who've mastered the steps to the lancers, the square set, the six-handed reel.
When we go to festivals outside of our own area, and they say the dancers are too long, they're too long to go on stage, and that's when you destroy them. Because, okay, you cut something out of them, and before long, that's permanently cut out of them, and you don't have them as they were. So if a dance is 15 minutes long, a dance is 15 minutes long. That's it.
This is what they did before we came, right?
Yeah. It's our culture, we got to keep it alive. If we don't
agree with that?
Yes.
But Burin's heritage goes beyond song and dance. Heritage House opened 3 years ago, a treasure chest of antiques, tangible reminders of days gone by, and a resource center for local school children who are given lessons in boat caulking, rug poking, and clothes scrubbing the old way.
Continuity is important from one generation to the next, and I think it's we all should know where we came from, because where we came from has a lot to do with where we are today and where we're going.
And they're going full tilt into the 90s, armed with the instruments of their past. This impromptu concert backstage at the festival is proof that the old ways are not limited to the old. Out on stage, the point is made again. One of the highlights of the Burin Folk Festival is a ceremony called Passing It On, where the older members of the community pass on traditions to the youngest members of their families, who seem quite intent on following in their footsteps.